I believe that the age that we're living in, that the sons of God are called to operate in such a greater level, a greater dimension of God. And I find that as Christians, we read the Bible, but there are many things in the Bible we don't believe. We proclaim that we believe the word of God, but we do not live the word of God. Why am I saying this? There are many miraculous events that we have seen happen in the Bible with the great prophets of ancient days. We've seen where God has used Elijah. God has used Moses. God has used Paul. We've seen where God has used these great men of God, you know, to do powerful, mighty works. And we've seen where when Lucifer was kicked out of heaven and he took a third of the angels, we're seeing that when Lucifer came into this dimension, his will, his plan and his agenda was and is to distort and to taint the things that are prophetic. So we watch movies and we see people walking through doors. We see people in one dimension and then suddenly they're in another place. We see people floating and levitating. And you know, now we have demonized all these things. We're calling, you know, someone being in one place, then suddenly they're in a whole different place. We're calling it astral projection. Everything has been demonized. And this is the plan of the enemy, to demonize the latter glory of God that's coming. So when it hits us, we're not open and ready to receive it. See, once upon a time, people were, you know, excited about, oh, women can, you know, wear makeup. We have come to the wisdom and the knowledge that makeup does not mean that you're not saved. Jewelry, as for women wearing jewelry, doesn't mean you're not saved. In fact, it's quite questionable, but you see men wearing jewelry, God is still using them. It's a whole crazy thing that's happening right now. But we've passed the era of debate of women can wear makeup and jewelry. We've passed the era of why are there so many problems. Everybody has a title. Everybody wants to prophesy and preach. We've now passed that. We're now in a stage where there is about to be a serious outpouring of the latter glory of God. And what is going to set prophets apart? What is going to show prophets of prophets and the sons of God? We will know that they are sons of God. Is not who can prophesy. Is not who can prophesy accurately and in precision. Is those that carry the glory. There are people who are anointed who do not serve God anymore. And so I've said that many people have built a platform on miracles and prophecy. We have to remember that Paul tells us in Romans, the gifts and callings of God are given without repentance. You can be anointed, you can be gifted, but you're not of God. And in this dispensation, what is going to set the true sons and prophets apart are those who are carriers of the glory of God. This means that you are coming to a stage in your life spiritually where God wants you to ascend, where even we're gonna see the days of old, the days of the Bible happening. You're gonna see where people who are in one place physically, but they're in two different dimensions at once. People will be hearing the voice and the thoughts of other persons. You are here, but your spirit left and you went to a whole different place. There's some that will demonize it and say that you're in astral projection and you're in some alternate universe and it's not of God. Y'all better be ready, for the sons of God are coming. We're gonna be living. We are living in multi-universe all at once. The Bible said that Enoch was here, suddenly he was not here. Elijah was here, suddenly he was no longer here. He was taken up into heaven. The Bible said that Elisha was in a certain place and his servant went to go meet with the king. And when he came back, he said, where are you coming from? His servant said, I didn't go anywhere. And Elisha said, did not my spirit go with you? There's coming a time where pandemics will rise up in the land and many of you will not be able to go and lay hands on the sick, but you will send your spirit. Some of you will demonize this. When we're raising the dead, when our spirit is going to different places, when God is transporting us in the spirit, some of you will call it demonic stuff like teleportation and whatever you call it. But in the spirit dimension, we're calling it translation. We're calling it transportation. The Bible said that when Peter was through baptizing this woman, the Bible said that when she looked around, Peter disappeared. He was no longer there. See, I'm no longer one for the preaching engagements. I'm no longer one for the microphone and being on platforms. I'm one that wants to be a custodian in the dimension and the realms of God. I want to carry the glory of God. When I enter an atmosphere, I want to go to heaven with people. I don't know if we're ready for this stuff, but I'm ready for some people to say, okay, this is spiritual witchcraft. Oh, you're doing too much. This is mysticism. Y'all better get ready for the wave of God that's about to hit the earth realm. It's not gonna be like the usual days. It's not gonna be just prophecy. You'll be praying and suddenly you will be like that man Paul said. Whether I know a man, whether he was in body or he was in spirit, I know a man that was caught up into the third heavens. These events and these experiences must become common and usual experiences among us. And we're looking at it as, oh, this was just Bible days. Oh, God was just making an example of something. No, these are things that will be happening in the earth realm even more frequently through the sons and the prophets of God. So I don't know what you are worrying about. You're worrying about warfare. You're worrying about preaching engagement. You're worrying about titles. We don't need to be worrying about all of that. What we need to be concerned about and praying about is that we will capture the glory of God in this season, and the earth realm will experience the glory of God, and the earth realm will experience the glory of God through you, because you are the catalyst through whom God is using, that we will see his glory like never before. What are you hungry for in this season? What are you pursuing in this season? God wants us to pursue the higher things of God. Paul says to think upon the things which are above, not the things which are beneath.